Hello everyone, my name is Austin, and today I'll be sharing the Monorock team I made for OU Ladder. I'm pretty new to competitive Pokemon, but I've always wanted to give it a go, and now that I play video games for a living, I figured now is a better time than ever to learn how to be good at this game. In this video, I'll be sharing why I made a Monorock team to begin with, my approach to building the team, and also some games I've played with it so far. So let's start with why I made a Monorock team in the first place. The reason why I made a Monorock team, or a Monotype team to begin with, is because in the competitive Pokemon metagame, there are just way too many Pokemon to think about, and rather than trying to learn all of them in one go, I decided to restrict the pool of Pokemon that I could even pick from. And one of the ways I thought about doing that was by picking a single type to go by. I picked Rock because it's one of the typings that have the least amount of Pokemon, and it's also considered one of the worst ones as well. So I figured that if I'm going to start at the bottom and learn the game, I might as well start at one of the lower spots possible that I can think of. And the reason why I want to play on the OU ladder rather than the Monotype ladder is because I eventually want to learn the OU metagame, and if I can make a Monotype team work on the actual ladder, then that would be kind of cool. I also like the idea of doing Monotype team because that means I can just kind of go through all the different types. And if I go through all the types and make a team for each type, then by the end of it all, I will have learned at least 108 different Pokemon. So that'll be cool. So let's jump into the team that I landed on. When I think about a rock team or a rock type Pokemon, I think about Tyranitar first because it's the one that sets up Sandstream, increases the special defense of all the rock type Pokemon on my team. I didn't want to play the regular Tyranitar set. I wanted to play a Choice Specs Tyranitar. It felt like if I picked a Specs Tyranitar that I'd be able to just delete some Pokemon off the board and give my other Pokemon a chance to perform. Tyranitar has a pretty decent spread of special attacks, so in order to figure out which ones I wanted to use, I went to the Pokelytics website to see which Pokemon are being used on the Gen 9 OU ladder. I kind of just cross-referenced this list with the list of special attacks that Tyranitar has, and this is the moveset I ended up landing on. Blizzard was a pretty standard pick because regular Tyranitar already runs Ice Beam for coverage. With the regular Tyranitar set, the Ice Beam won't OKO those mons, it'll just hit them decently hard. But with Specs, Ice Beam will actually kill most of these. The only Pokemon on that list that Ice Beam doesn't OKO is the Raging Bolt, Iron Valiant, and Dragonite. So that's why I ended up running Blizzard. I also just think it's funny to run Blizzard, a less accurate but more powerful move over Ice Beam, which would be more reliable. Same thing with running Fire Blast over Flamethrower. And I originally had Focus Blast on here, but in my testing games, I never ended up clicking Focus Blast for anything. And I ended up putting Terra Blast on here for Terra Flying to cover Pokemon like Great Tusk and Zamazenta. Zamazenta being one of the ones that kind of just destroys my team, so this is kind of nice to have. Terra Flying would also sometimes OKO a Volcarona, or at least resist a Giga Drain. And then Thunder, I had it on here to deal with Water Pokemon because I have a Rock-type team, so it would make sense that Water-type Pokemon would be good against a Rock-type team. But it wasn't as useful as I thought because a lot of the switch-ins for Tyranitar were like Iron Tread, so it's immune anyway, or Archaladon, which resists Electric anyway. I upped the defense on this since the Spidef will already be boosted by the Sand most of the time, obviously, plus Special Attack. Just hit things as hard as I can. That was a goal for Tyranitar. So now that I have this, I have to build the rest of my team around this. Tyranitar is not going to be the win condition. It's going to be the Pokemon that clears the way for my win cons, which ended up being Arcanine, Hisui, and Garganacle. Both of these have pretty standard sets, actually. Choice Band, Arcanine, with Rock Head, and then just the hardest hitting moves that I can think of. I'm pretty sure this is just the standard set. Flare Blitz, Close Combat, Head Smash, and Extreme Speed. Jolly Nature, just in case I need to outspeed something. I didn't really do any calcs to see which Pokemon would outspeed an Adamant Arcanine, but either way, this should hit pretty hard anyway with the Choice Band. Terra Flying, again, because I felt like instead of boosting one type of move, it might be better to just become immune or resistant to one with Terra Flying and be able to hit twice, then try to add damage to one more attack. And this Terra Flying is going to be a pretty consistent thing that you're going to see on this team, just because Rock is weak to ground and fighting, and then Flying is immune to ground and resistant to fighting, so it ends up being very useful. Flying also resists grass too. For Garganacle, I went with the Curse set. If as long as I can delete some of the Pokemon that would give Garganacle problems with like Tyranitar or Arcanine or one of my other Pokemon in the back, then this Garganacle will just live forever. I gave it Spidef, like a specially defensive set, which paired with the Sand is a pretty high Spidef stat. And I don't need to worry about defense because I gave it Curse. Most of the time I'll be saving my Terra for Garganacle because Terra Flying Garganacle just kind of put in a lot of work in a lot of my battles. The other three Pokemon are like backup plans to help me get rid of certain other Pokemon. I have a pretty standard Glamora set here, except instead of it being a hazard setter, I just had it be another type of Pokemon with coverage that can do damage for one of my other Pokemon to finish it off. You'll notice that I didn't go for a lot of Rock Stab on these Pokemon just because Rock type attacks aren't very effective against a lot of the Pokemon in the OU metagame, so I just didn't really worry about that too much. And I also threw on Mortal Spin for some hazard control, and also to badly poison any threat that wants to try to set up on my team as well. A badly poisoned Pokemon plus Assault Cure can make enemies switch out pretty hard. My last lines of defense really are the Avalokitsui and the Alolan Golem. Avalokitsui is kind of like my counter to any special attacker that gets out of control. We got Heavy Duty Boots and Sturdy, plus Mirror Coat, so as long as it's not a special attacking dark type, I should be good. They shouldn't be expecting a Mirror Coat from Avalug. As long as I can keep Avalug healthy, it should be able to just Mirror Coat any special attacker that gets out of control. And much like that, I have the physical version of that in Alolan Golem with Heavy Duty Boots Sturdy with counter for any physical mon that gets out of control. As far as the rest of their moveset, Avalug, I have the standard body press stuff on there. If they happen to switch into Goldengo, Stomping Tantrum will OKO it if I miss with the body press or a Mirror Coat because of the doubled power, which is kind of nice. And if the Goldengo has an air balloon, I have Crunch ready for it. And I have the Terra type Dark that'll help me OKO the Goldengo if I know that it's coming in with an air balloon. So that's kind of fun to have. And then for Alolan Golem, I have Thunder Wave. In case of paralysis will help me a lot. I didn't end up clicking this a lot, so this set kind of needs a little bit of work. I have the Supercell Slam, just to have an electric stab type. I also had never seen this move before, so I kind of just threw it on there, just because. And then threw on Explosion and Terra type Normal in case I need to get more damage on that. I do have an adamant nature Alolan Golem. I originally had the Ogerpon Wellspring, or not Wellspring, but whatever the rock type one was, I had the Ogerpon on there. Because it had Sturdy, and I was mostly using it for the same thing that Golem was doing. I had like a Sturdy counter type set, but the fact that it was an Ogerpon meant that it couldn't have Heavy Duty Boots, and since I wasn't going too much for hazard control on this team, it ended up not netting me a lot of value. And the grass typing on it didn't really help me against this metagame at all, so I ended up just swapping it out for this Pokemon instead. Just needed a different rock type that had Sturdy that could wear Heavy Duty Boots, and it was between this and Sudowoodo. I think those are my only options really, and yeah, I didn't want to go with Sudowoodo. But yeah, that's the basic overview of this team. Another thing too, before I had Arcanine Hisui on here, I also had Minior instead for the rock flying. I thought that the flying type would help me a lot since it was immune to ground types, but I found that Minior took a little bit too long to set up for this team in particular. Like, I didn't really have a way to set up Minior for a sweep, and the fact that it wasn't resistant to fighting hurt my team quite a bit. I found that having the option to Terra Flying on any of these at any point in time was a bit more useful than having Minior on my team. And Arcanine Hisui just hits a lot harder, a lot faster. No need to set up, just click a move while banded and then switch into something else. So yeah, that's kind of the thought process behind building this team. So let's go take a look at some of the games that I played. So I have four different games to showcase. I have this game, which is a game against the highest rated person that I've faced on the ladder. And then I have a showcase against three different rain teams that I played against. So looking at this team, it's a pretty scary team, just has a bunch of different threats. Looking at this team, the one that makes the most sense, I think, to lead with is their Great Tusk. Maybe they can set up rocks or something, or they can just headlong rush or close combat depending on what I send out. So I decide to go with the Glimmora lead here. It was either going to be Glimmora or Tyranitar. Those are like the two more standard leads for this team, but they end up leading with Slowking, which was out of my expectation. So I decided to just hit it with a super effective Earth Power just to see what it would do. I wasn't expecting it to do much, just because, you know, Slowking is especially defensive Pokemon, but I kind of just wanted to see. And it ended up using Surf, which I wasn't expecting. Didn't do all that much, didn't expect it to. So since it's deciding to attack me, I just switch into my Garganacle just to start getting some Salt Cures off. I knew that it could tank a Surf. This was also before I started running the Curse set, so instead of Curse, I had Body Press on here, which I ended up not clicking very much, and why I ended up switching to Curse instead. Because Body Press doesn't even really hit anything on this team, except for King Gambit, unfortunately. But I mean, it tends to be enough. I get a crit there, doesn't really matter though. And then we see a Future Sight come out, which I also wasn't expecting. But because they Future Sighted, and because they were low, I felt like they were gonna switch out into a different Pokemon at that time. So instead of protecting or recovering, I decided to just go for Assault Cure again to get the Assault Cure off on whatever they switch into, which ends up being this Great Tusk here. And I decide to scout the Great Tusk with a Protect, and they want to hit me with a Headlong Rush, which is cool. And I'm glad I protected, because I didn't know that Future Sight could hit through the Protect like that. But if I didn't die to the Headlong Rush, I would have for sure died to the Future Sight. So let's see what I decide to do here. I don't entirely remember. Okay, I decide to just sack Glimmora here. But they use Stealth Rock. I'm expecting them to just kill my Glimmora here, but they end up... Let's see. Yeah, they end up switching back into Slowking. And I'm Mortal Spinned to see if I could just badly poison any of these other Pokemon that they could have sent out. They end up switching into one of two Pokemon that this wouldn't affect. But I guess they were playing it a little bit safe because I had only revealed Earth Power beforehand, and I could have very well been a Scarf Glamora set. So yeah, Mortal Spin doesn't end up doing much. But I do clear the Stealth Rock. Oh, okay, no, the main reason was to clear the Stealth Rocks. What am I talking about? But yeah, I'm still down with sacking the Glamora, so I hit a little Earth Power to try and force the Slowking out here. And switching into Arcanine Hisui, something's gonna have to eat an attack from me here. I don't think they're gonna let their Slowking go. They're probably gonna sack something else. So I'm looking at the different Pokemon that they can send out. I don't entirely remember the reason why I went with this move, but I ended up clicking Rock Smash, or Head Smash, and it ends up working out, taking out Gouging Fire. I feel like they could have switched into a different Pokemon. Like, I feel like Great Tusk would have been fine. I don't know if there's a Pokemon. Oh, you know what? It's because I'm faster. I'm faster than Great Tusk. So Great Tusk would get 2-hit KO by whatever I put out. That's why they didn't do that. But either way, we take out Gouging Fire. I guess they probably didn't think Gouging Fire would be too useful against a Monorock team. So we claim that one. Send out Dragapult. I switched to Tyranitar here. And they T-Wave. I wasn't expecting that, honestly. But I guess T-Wave is a sign of it being a Hex Dragapult set. I didn't know this at the time, but it is something that I learned from this. But yeah, I switched into Tyranitar, and now that, because it didn't hit me, I get to let off one of my Choice Specs attacks. So now I'm thinking about which button to click. I see a Dragapult in front of me, I'm clicking Blizzard. Actually, the only Pokemon it won't kill is King Gambit here, so I click Blizzard here. It actually switched into Iron Valiant, and this is where I learned that Blizzard just kind of destroys Iron Valiant. Yeah, it didn't OKO it on its own. But with the Sandstorm, it's able to just take it out in one go, which is kind of nice. Now we see the Slowking Galar at 64%, and I'm pretty sure I just click Blizzard again just to see if it'll take out the 64% Slowking. But they switch out to give Slowking more health. Oh, I don't click it. I just switch out. I feel like I should have just clicked Blizzard and let it rip. Blizzard would have been good because if it switched out into anything, it would have just hit really hard. I could have claimed Great Tusk right then and there, but it's cool. I switched to Garganacle probably just to gain some health back, and actually I kind of want to look at that one again. So. Yeah, Garganacle. They now know that my Glamora with Mortal Spin is down. So I decide to click Salt Cure here, because I've already shown Salt Cure and Protect. So they're probably thinking that I'm gonna Protect to gain more health back. Or they just want to get their rocks up for the rest of the game, so I'd use that opportunity to get my own Salt Cure up on this Great Tusk. Kinda nice. And yeah, they seem to be switching out quite a bit from these Salt Cures. So instead of Protecting, I decide to go for another Salt Cure to hit whatever comes back in, which ends up being their Slowking Galar, so I get another Salt Cure off, which is fine. And then I switch back into Tyranitar? Okay. Okay, yeah, I'm pretty sure I switched back into Tyranitar, because they were probably just gonna switch back out of their Slowking to get its regenerator back out. And since my Tyranitar is at mostly full health, I saw an opportunity to get off another Choice Spec special attack. So, yeah, and just to secure it too, this is where I finally Terra flying with my Tyranitar. Should be expecting the Headlong Rush, and Headlong Rush would have killed for sure, so I just get the Blizzard off and take out the Great Tusk with Tyranitar, which is exactly why I'm running Choice Specs on this thing. They switch into Dragapult here. I'm not entirely sure why. The Hex doesn't kill, but I get paralyzed, so the Blizzard doesn't happen. But if it did, it would have absolutely just destroyed this Dragapult. But it's okay, I still have a decent amount of Pokemon in the back. I switched to Garganacle here because Hex isn't going to do anything to it, and I live a Draco Meteor as well, so I can just get a free recover off here on this turn. They end up missing the Draco Meteor, which doesn't really matter actually. But yeah, I get back to 100%. They land this time, yeah, 36%. I get a Salt Cure off, some damage going, you know, some standard stuff, and they just forfeit because there's not much that their team can do after that. I'm going to slowly whittle away. The Arcanine's just going to beat the Slowking, I'm pretty sure. And for King Gambit, I had the Ogre Pond with counter as well, and also just a Salt Cure. I get one Salt Cure off, and it's over. That opponent was rated 1224, I was 1141 at the time, and then went up to 1172. Let's go into the rain battles. This is the first rain team that I played against with my team, which is kind of like a weird rain team, honestly. Like, the Pelipper, Archaludon, and Barrascuda trio is one that you normally see on a rain team, especially since Archaludon is currently being suspect tested. It's the other half of the team that's kind of interesting. You got Gouging Fire, Cinderace, and Grimmsnarl. Grimmsnarl to set up screens and probably be a bit more offensive, but I'm not entirely sure what the vision was for Gouging Fire and Cinderace. If they have Grimmsnarl, I should be expecting the Grimmsnarl lead. So I led with Glamora to just kind of start sending some poison attacks off onto it. But they're gonna get the Light Screen up, so my Sludge Wave isn't gonna hit it very hard, but I get the poison off, which is kind of nice. And I'm just going to keep clicking Sludge Wave, because why not? Just get this Grimmsnarl down and off the field. And at this point, I'm expecting them to switch out, potentially, just so they can keep their Grimmsnarl. And I end up clicking Earth Power, even though I maybe should have expected Pelipper. So I was kind of looking at Archaludon as a potential switch-in, just because I was letting Sludge Waves off, and Archaludon is immune to that. So I could have been giving off that I might have been scarfed, locked into a Sludge Wave, which would have forced me to switch out against Archaludon. But after playing against a few more rain teams, I noticed that Archaludon doesn't normally go out unless there's rain because of its electro shot move or whatever it's called. So looking back, I shouldn't have been expecting this, and I could have just let the Sludge Waves keep going. But it ends up not mattering because they keep the Grimmsnarl in. But now they know that I'm not choiced, so that should affect how they do their next move. But they send out Gouging Fire. I don't think sending out Gouging Fire is going to help that much because my Earth Power will still hit it super effectively. Probably not very hard because of the light screen. I'm also sashed, so I can at least get two moves off. Or at least one. I get one move off because it's faster. So I decide to hit it with a Mortal Spin to badly poison this Pokemon that's boosted. So even if they decide to kill my Glamora, they'll be taking poison for two turns. Or if they switch out, then they will have wasted their booster energy, which is good for me either way. Glamora's already done a decent job. It's getting even more extra credit, actually. It's faster. I was faster than their Gouging Fire somehow. Oh yeah, it's attack boosted, so they're probably adamant, not jolly. So I end up getting a lot of extra credit there. And I switch to Garganacle because I don't think this Gouging Fire is going to be able to deal with me. Yeah, I just tank that Earthquake pretty nicely and get this Salt Cure out just to get that Gouging Fire completely off the board. And at this point, I don't think they're going to switch out, so I just Protect, get some health back. I don't need to rip my Terra Flying just yet. Yeah. Now they send out Pelipper, they're going to pivot into their Rain setup. So I just get rid of their Rain right away with Tyranitar. But I wasn't expecting them to just let a Surf go with their Pelipper. I was expecting them to switch into Archaludon or Barrascuda, maybe, but that ends up doing quite a bit. 52%, but it's going to do less now that it's not in the rain. Actually, no, it just kills. But that's okay. Yeah, I just go back into Garganacle. They're not going to kill Garganacle with the Surf, so I recover on the switch. And I see a Cinderace. I'm expecting like a high jump kick here or something, so I Protect. And because I Protected, they're going to lose half their health to that high jump kick. And I don't really have anything that I want to switch into here, because Arcanine dies to the high jump kick. Ogerpon and Avalug have Sturdy, so they'll live one high jump kick, but that kind of defeats the purpose of them having Sturdy, because Ogerpon's supposed to be the counter to the physical attacker, but it won't get a counter off if it's already at one health. And Avalug, I'm saving for their Archaludon, the special attacker. Ogerpon, I would have saved for this, but it has to be full health. And it's also a good counter to Barrascuda as well. So this is a good time, or like a perfect time really, for me to use my Terra Flying against this high jump kick. Yeah, just resist it really nicely, get the Salt Cure off, get the Cinderace off the board. Probably start getting it off the board at least. They miss the Pyro Ball, I don't think it matters all that much either way, but yeah. Cinderace goes down, should be expecting the Pelipper to set off the rain, and instead of letting the Surfs off, it's no longer super effective. This is where they send out the Archaludon, but I got the Salt Cure, and since it's a Steel type, it's going to be doing 25% per turn, which is pretty strong. But yeah, even look at this, the Electroshock actually wouldn't have killed, but it killed because it hit a critical hit, which is kind of messed up. But this is exactly why I have the Avalug. We got the Flash Cannon coming out and the Mirror Coat. There's no way that Archaludon presses Body Press here just because of how defensive Avalug is. But if they did click Body Press, then I would have been in some trouble, actually. I didn't know that Archaludon ran Body Press until after this game, or until later on, but I was glad that they went with Flash Cannon instead. But yeah, Avalug does its job, Barrascuda is just going to clean up as it does, which is fine. Don't need it anymore. And Ogerpon, there's no way that they're expecting a counter, but they should be expecting a grass move at least. Yeah, they just keep going with Liquidation. I get the counter off. I could have used IV Cudgel instead, probably would have Oko'd anyway, but we go with counter. And then all that's left is this Pelipper, which will take out the Ogerpon. They actually are. Actually, that Terra, they would have died. They would have died if this Power Whip landed. That's another thing. I was running Power Whip over Ivy Cudgel just because I think Power Whip does more based on what I saw on the calcs. And I also thought it was funny to run Power Whip because I was already running like Blizzard, Fire Blast, Focus Blast on Tyranitar. I was like, why not just run a bunch of moves that miss? So yeah, I pay for it there. and it's going to come up to whether or not this rock smash lands on this Pelipper. I'm not sure if close combat Oko's Pelipper here, and Fire Blast definitely does not Oko in the rain, and neither does Extreme Speed. So yeah, I end up landing the head smash, the non-100% head smash, and win this battle. The next rain team is closer to what you'd usually see on a rain team. I'd say the standout one is a Deoxys Defense, but all the other ones, pretty standard stuff. I'm not entirely sure what goes in this slot usually, but I just remember it not really being Deoxys. Looking back, it makes sense to just lead Tyranitar, because most of the time a rain team will lead Pelipper, and I can just get rain off immediately. And because I get the rain off immediately on turn 1, I should be expecting a switch out of Pelipper, and I can abuse that fact to just let a Choice Specs Tyranitar move off. But I went with Arcanine Hisui. I was expecting them to lead with Deoxys Defense, and I was kind of hoping to hit it pretty hard. If they switched into Deoxys Defense, I would have done about 57 to 67%, so I would have just 2-hit KO this thing, as long as I was faster. And it looks like it would have been a speed tie, but it was a speed tie I was willing to go for. But they end up switching to Iron Treads, and I missed the head smash, so it doesn't even matter that Iron Treads quad resists that, I just missed. So, switch into Tyranitar, at least get rid of the rain. And Earth Power does nothing because of the Sandstorm's Fidef increase, which is kind of nice. And they decide to Earth Power again, which I feel might have been a little greedy, and I get the Fire Blast off just to take out the Iron Treads for good, which is kind of nice. And then Beraskuda is going to claim one, but I'm not going to let it claim one for free. I'm going to switch to Glimmora, and now that puts up spikes on their side of the field. Pelipper obviously unaffected. But I'm actually faster than the Pelipper, so I get a Toxic off on this Pelipper through Mortal Spin, which is kind of nice. I guess if I Sludge Waved, I would have hit it a bit harder, but this Poison is kind of nice to have. And Glimmora was meant to die anyway, so it's cool. Now I switch into Garganacle, the beast that he is. Not sure why I didn't just switch back into Tyranitar to get the rain, or to get the rain away, but it's the decision that I went with. I actually get a Salt Cure off because Pelipper stays in and surfs, so Pelipper is basically dead. And I use that opportunity to use my Terra Flying and recover more health than I would have if I just clicked Protect. So yeah. Now that I'm Terra Flying and this Pelipper is going down, I should be expecting either Archaludon or Raging Bolt, both of which have the tools to deal with this flying Garganacle. So we see the Archaludon, we should see an Electro Shot coming here. I'm pretty sure... Oh no, okay. Then for some reason, I switch into Tyranitar, thinking, oh okay, well, if I do this, then Electro Shot's gonna be a two-turn move. But really, this just kind of sacks my Tyranitar instead, which doesn't really do much, and I'm one less turn of Sandstorm, because Archaludon's not even affected by Sandstorm anyway. But I use this opportunity now to switch into Arcanine. I probably would have just been fine with Garganacle, to be honest. But actually, no, because now that it's plus one attack, it'll be a little bit more tough to deal with. But I figured Arcanine with Fire Blast should do, or not Fire Blast, but Flare Blitz should do a decent amount here. Yeah, 2-hit KO on this Archaludon. Body Press isn't quite enough to kill me, so yeah, take out the Archaludon. Big threat off the board, Suspect Test gone. And they bring out the Beraskuda, so they're going to claim one here. I look at the team that I have left. Garganacle, which might be useful against Deoxys Defense. I'm keeping Golem Sturdy intact for this Beraskuda later. And then Avalug, I'm keeping that fully intact for the Raging Bolt also, so I can get some Mirror Coat action going. So I actually decide to sack my Arcanine here. I think it's just the best course of action. So yeah. Now I bring out Garganacle. They shouldn't be able to Oko my Garganacle here. I Protect and get some health back. They Terra Watered. I don't think it would have killed me here, but they're going to take some extra poison damage. So that way when I land the Salt Cure here, it reduces the amount of turns that it'll stay. Actually, no, it doesn't even reduce the amount of turns it'll stay alive, but I don't know. It's kind of nice. Worked out. And the Beraskuda goes down. All that's left, Deoxys Defense, Raging Bolt. Not sure what Deoxys Defense will do. I didn't even look up what set it would do. But I switched to Alolan Golem now, because it's not, now that Beraskuda is off the board, Iron Treads is off the board, it's not going to do much for me. So I was cool with just doing what I could with this Golem here, and maybe getting some extra damage off or something. I'm not sure. Deoxys is faster than me, so I'm glad that I used the explosion here just to get extra 42% off. Plus 6% because of the Toxic Spikes plus Leftovers. And then Protecting just to get some more poison damage off, but they read it and they get the Cosmic Power. But I'm not too worried. Stored Power doesn't kill here, because Garganacle is a beast and I have Spidef invested. So They decided to Cosmic Power again, probably expecting another Protect, but I expect them to go for a Cosmic Power this time, and I just Salt Cure. And now I just get a free Protect. I just don't even let them get the extra chip from stored power here, and get a little bit more health back before we go and see this Raging Bolt. But Raging Bolt's gonna be poisoned. It's not gonna Oko my Flying Garganacle, even with Thunderclap. So, yeah, now it's Salt Cured, poisoned. It's just not gonna win this. And even if it does kill my Garganacle, I have the Avalug with Miracote, and I just click Miracote up to 8 times. It's either gonna have to... It's gonna have to attack me eventually, and unless it's a physical set, then it's not gonna have any shot at winning. But with Calm Mind, and also Avalug's super high defense, it's not gonna kill my Avalug faster than it's gonna die to Salt Cure and Poison. So I ended up winning this one as well. And we'll go into the last Rain Team showcase for this video. This one is a Rain Team that doesn't use Pelipper. I looked at this team and had no idea what to expect from it, actually. I end up leading Tyranitar just to kind of let off a move from the start, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I tried Fire Blasting because it's Bug type, and that would have been nice to land. But yeah, since I missed, I swap out because I'm expecting them to expect the Fire Blast, and I go to Glamora to get rid of the Sticky Webs. Anything that gets rid of hazards is still cool with me. And this is where the rain comes into play. They're playing a Rain Dance Vikavolt, which is fun. And they end up blocking my Mortal Spin with the Archaludon. I probably should have expected this switch now that the rain's up. I eventually learned that Archaludon is the mon that comes in after setting up the rain because they want to set up their Electro Shot and all that. But yeah, this one was a weird one. It wasn't the standard Electro Shot set. They used Iron Defense, which didn't help them at all because I just get a super strong Earth Power off and basically kill this thing. And now the Electro Shot comes in, but it's a little too late now because I'm able to just take out their Archaludon with a Glimmora, which is really nice. Then they switch into their Dragonite, so I should be expecting like a Dragon Dance here. But they just Hurricane to get rid of the Glimmora, which is an interesting choice. I'm pretty sure I clicked Mortal Spin just to get the Dragonite toxic. But maybe that's why they Hurricane. They didn't want to get the poison damage off on this. But I switch into Tyranitar here and then break their... Oh, I guess I didn't break their multi-scale on this turn. But watch this. This is the reason why I included this game in this showcase, because Choice Specs Blizzard on a multi-scale Dragonite did 99% to that Dragonite and then ends up taking it out with the Sandstorm damage. But like, imagine if it took it out 100%, that would have been insane. But yeah, they switch out, they bring out Vikavolt now, presumably to set the rain back up for Barrascuda. Pretty sure I just let off a Blizzard here. Doesn't kill the Vikavolt to my surprise, but that's fine. And they switch it into Blissey, because I probably caught on now that I'm running a special attacking Tyranitar and Blissey's just going to tank everything. So I switched into Garganacle expecting this. So now I can Salt Cure this thing or even potentially start setting up. But they have a Water Pulse Blissey, which is pretty interesting. I Salt Cure just to start getting some chip on this thing. And I'm pretty sure I'm running the Cursed set here. So we're both going to start boosting up. They got a Calm Mind Blissey versus my Cursed Garganacle in the rain. But I think this is good for me because I feel like they shouldn't be setting up a Blissey. It's just taking up rain turns now. I feel like they would have been better off just letting something rip with Barrascuda, but I'm not the one running the rain team. And that Water Pulse ends up doing 45%, which is like not nothing. So really they're actually just kind of cooking with this. But I just get to protect, waste some of their rain turns as well. And I'm pretty sure I let the Terra Flying rip here. No, I'm just saying I'm going to tank this Water Pulse and recover. Saving the Terra for something else, I suppose. Oh, I saved it for there. Okay. Wasn't expecting them to Stealth Rock, but that's kind of fine. You go back into Vikavolt. I think they're going to set up the rain one more time for their Barrascuda. But I know that they're going to Rain Dance, so I get another curse off just to make sure that I can live whatever Barrascuda has to offer. I'm already Terra Flying as well. But they end up having Thunderbolt. Wasn't expecting that. I probably should have, considering that Vikavolt is a bug electric type, so I probably should have just attacked with Salt Cure to get that Vikavolt out of here. I protect to rain at, or to waste at least one more rain turn, and I switch into Tyranitar to get the rain out of here, and so I can live with Thunderbolt as well, which is kind of nice. But they're not going to let my Tyranitar kill. Oh, they are, actually. They went for rain, and I clicked Thunder just because I knew it wouldn't miss if they went for Rain Dance. And if they went into Barrascuda, I would have killed it. They only could have switched into Metagross, but why would you switch into Metagross here? Not really sure. But yeah, Barrascuda comes in. I switch out. Oh, to get rid of the Swift Swim. and also the water stab. I actually don't even need to. I'm pretty sure I just switch into Golem here. And they liquidate. I probably should have just countered here, but I think I haven't clicked on the Supercell Slam button up until this point, so I decided to click that. So I had a 5% chance of just losing this game here. But even if I didn't click that, I think I would have been able to still win with Avalug. Not through Miracote means, but maybe through like a crunch or a body press or something. Since Bereskuta is pretty squishy. And all that's left is this Metagross. Gotta see what kind of set it has. Bullet Punch, which is pretty interesting. I don't think Metagross usually runs a physical set. Not entirely sure. Not a very common mon in this tier. I think it's one of the only time I saw it. And now we see a Heavy Slam also. I have no idea what to expect other than for it to die to a Flare Blitz. So I end up winning this game as well. Those are the most interesting games I've played with my Monorock team. Next time I do one of these Monotype teams, I'll do a live commentary of the games that I'm playing instead of after the fact. But that'll be the end of this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.